новая комета. Мы счастливые люди нашей планеты. Каждый день зажигаем мы лучи. Кванты Qubit наши главные ключи. Живем сегодня, а завтра будет лучше. Мы растем, развиваемся дальше. Столько нового на нашем пути. Если ты со мной, об этом не молчи. Наше будущее в наших руках. Инвестиции растут в кошельках. Ты скорее включайся в команду, чтоб качать QubitTech города. Трейдеры сегодня работают за нас. Инвестируй в технологии прямо сейчас. Мы работаем в новейшей компании в мире. Роботы сделают богаче каждого из вас. QubitTech, несомненно, QubitTech. Самый ценный QubitTech. Прямо сейчас QubitTech сделал лучшими каждого из нас. QubitTech is the best. QubitTech, make investments. QubitTech, have a rest. QubitTech, fast and easy, brought us to success. On our super machine, we are fast moving towards our dream. If you take it today and for real, you could have a new business deal. I boldly give you my respect for logging into QubitTech. Let's make a good job all together. Rank by rank, we don't have tether. Every day we invite many friends. Our way to success never ends. We have done our awesome quick start, so that all have a chance to take part. We all live in the present future. Trading and investing is our culture. If you didn't know, now you know. It's time to join, let's go. QubitTech, несомненно, QubitTech. Самый ценный QubitTech. Прямо сейчас QubitTech сделал лучшими каждого из нас. QubitTech is the best. QubitTech, make investments. QubitTech, have a rest. QubitTech, fast and easy, brought us to success. QubitTech, несомненно, QubitTech. Самый ценный QubitTech. Прямо сейчас QubitTech сделал лучшими каждого из нас. QubitTech is the best. QubitTech, make investments. QubitTech, have a rest. QubitTech, fast and easy, brought us to success.
Thank you. Новое время, у нас новые дороги, у нас новые возможности.
То, что я увидел сегодня на презентации, это реально level up. Огромный плюс здесь, вы делаете результат каждый день. Every day вы получаете ваши деньги. QubitTech! Здесь 40 машин! 100 миллионеров долларов! Прямо здесь! No matter where you are in the world, no matter what you are doing, no matter how you are doing it, give us a shot to make your family, your friends, and your loved ones just a little bit happier, just a little bit wealthier. Give us some trust, some faith, and some confidence, and we're going to change your life.
Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, wherever you are. I don't know where you are. I know where I am. And it's a wonderful day out here. And we're going to make it even more wonderful. You know why? Because we're all here. We got together here to understand how to make profit. And you know what? The profit is the name of the game that we're all playing. I mean, that's what keeps us in the market. I mean, that's what makes our life sparkle. Well, at least my life. If it's not the same way for you, I mean, just listen carefully and maybe you change your mind. Name of the game is profit, and it's very easy to make profit in this market. And the way you do it is very, very simple. You buy something for less money than you sell it for, and you are in profit. My name is Leon Rubelsky, Dr. Leon Rubelsky. I am not the kind of doctor who treats your stomachache or headache or God forbid corona. I'm a kind of doctor who helps you with your financial wealth. And this is what we're going to do within next series of these webinars, of these meetings, I would say. It's not really like, it's really like a meeting with all of you. And I'm a doctor of financial wealth, but actually I'm a doctor in physics and with very, very good education in math. And that helped me to work out my own strategies, work out my own approach to the market. I'm in the market for many, many years now, since late 90s. That was a stock market before, then it was became Forex market. I'm very good expert in that. And for the last several years, I'm a trader in cryptocurrency market and an expert, and I'm teaching how to do it. And teaching the understanding of what to do. The market itself, the cryptocurrency market, is very, very young compared to other markets, and we will talk about it a little bit later. But because it's only like Bitcoin is only 11 years old, and the market, let's say the market is about the same age. So what are we going to do? What are we going to learn? And where are we going to end up? We're going to talk about what virtual currency is, because the virtual currency is something that we deal with. I mean, if you don't understand what it is, well, basically, QubitTech will still trade for you, but I would like you to understand what quantum algorithmic technologies of QubitTech are doing for you. I mean, it's very, very important to understand, but actually, you can just sit and relax and just watch from the side. Okay, so the virtual currency is something that broke into our life like a heavy truck. I mean, fast supercar. And there is basically no, at this moment, I don't think there is a company in the world, I mean, like important company, big company, which doesn't consider using cryptocurrency, which doesn't do research in that respect. And I found this saying of, I honestly, I don't know this guy, Thomas Carper, he is a US senator. I don't know whether he is going to be a senator for much longer with what has happened in the US right now. But basically, that actually reflects the view of business community, political community, economical community, any kind, that Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies are something that is going to be with us for long. So we will not be able to understand and talk about cryptocurrency without understanding what blockchain is very, very unproductive, I would say that. I will, in very, very simple words, I'll explain what blockchain is. It's not going to be, of course, full definition. It's not going to be precise definition, but it will help you understand. If you need to go further, you will understand it. Because like regular definition, I mean, you see it on your screen, it's a block of chain, growing list of records, and so on and so on. I will explain it in a very, very simple way. Just imagine you're writing a book, and you're writing a page in the book, and beside you, there are hundreds, thousands, maybe millions of people who are writing the pages. And let's say you're writing the page number 125. In this page, everything that's been written in the book from page 1 to page 124 is taken care of on this page. Your page is based on that. When you finish this page, and only you can write it. When you finish this page, the next one that is going to be in action, page number 126, is going to have records of everything that's been before from page 1 to page 125 now. What does it mean? It means one very, very simple thing. There is no way to change what's been written before, which means the block and the pages that you're writing are not going to be able to have all the information, and it cannot be altered. So in the blockchain, these pages are called blocks, and the whole information is called blockchain, because it's very, very simple. I mean, the definition speaks for itself. And these blocks are connected each one with each other through cryptographic hash. A hash is a special function, that cryptographic function connects that. And each one has time when it's created, and the data, actually, the content on what is written on this page, which is the most important thing, of course. And this cryptographic hash is like mathematical algorithm which connects the data array in a particular way. And for each cryptocurrency, it's its own. And the value of this hash is something that you cannot alter, as I said. This is probably, let me tell you one important thing. Everything that we're talking about right now is, I'm just defining what we will be able to cover in the series of our meetings, because Of course, we'll talk more about blockchain. Of course, we'll talk more about virtual currencies. But right now, just the taste of what we're going to be dealing with in future. So what is cryptocurrency? Basically, you can read what's written on the screen. I mean, there isn't much to add to it. Basically, the most important thing is that it's an asset created by a particular software for a particular group of users. That's the most important thing. It can be used on your computer. It could be stored on your wallet. We'll talk later about it. And also, these wallets could be hardware wallets. Like I'm sure you all seen these little devices that look like USB ports, but they sometimes, these little USB ports, not ports, I mean devices, sometimes hold millions and millions of dollars, which I wish all of you have sometime soon. The most important feature of the cryptocurrency is that it's not controlled by any government, by any entity, by bank, by nothing in the world. It's what's called peer-to-peer application, and it's done, it's designed, and we will see a little bit later that it's not always like that, but it's designed to eliminate a middleman. A middleman is somebody, something that not only controls what you are doing, and we don't like this word control, but also an entity that takes a portion of your money, because if somebody does something for you, it's obvious that he or she or it should be paid for it. So in cryptocurrency, when we deal with cryptocurrency, we're eliminating this, we're eliminating possibility, necessity of somebody who is controlling what you are doing. So how is it called? It's called decentralized environment. So the blockchain is like the name of the game for the decentralized environment. And the blockchain created currencies, and again, I'm running a little bit ahead, not all cryptocurrencies are blockchain-based, we'll talk about it a little bit later. So the blockchain-defined cryptocurrency immunes the cryptocurrency from entrance, from altering by any interference and control from anybody. And these cryptocurrencies, as I said, could be sent directly between two different parties. We call it peer-to-peer, as I said already, but it could be in private or it could be through exchange. We'll talk a little bit about exchange just in a few minutes and in short, but in like major details, we'll talk about it in future future meetings. To say that today cryptocurrency became a global phenomenon, say nothing. I mean, cryptocurrency is on the, I mean, just recently, and I'll show it to you next time, I've seen a jacket, which from such a, nobody else, but Balenciaga, has the word Bitcoin on it. So major companies are in on the hype. So what we are going to, it's all nice. I mean, it's not nice to understand what is cryptocurrency, what is blockchain, and how it changes our life. This is not what we're here for. We're here to understand how to trade Bitcoin, any cryptocurrency, and how to invest in it. So, as I said, the first step we already mapped out, and it is to understand blockchain and other cryptocurrencies. And basically, we will, at the end of this series, we will have a very, very strong, solid working knowledge to understand and discuss any cryptocurrency in any situation. You will be able to buy, trade, transfer, secure them on different wallets or in different exchanges. You will be able to you will understand what an exchange is and how to use it perfectly for what you're doing. And for understanding the trading, which is the most important thing, you will understand how to identify the entry point, which cryptocurrency to use, to choose, and you will, I will explain and help you to understand, and I'm sure everybody is familiar with these terms, both fundamental and technical analysis for cryptocurrency market. Fundamental analysis for somebody who is not yet in it, it's something that defines the change in the value of a certain asset, in our case, cryptocurrency, based on economical events in the world, political events, like the event that just, well, it's not finished yet, actually. The election in the US affected every possible way of economic life and of the market life. Many stocks went up and down, and the indices changed a lot, and the cryptocurrencies as well. That is defined by fundamental analysis. And we're talking about technical analysis, something different. It's more my cup of tea, because technical analysis is based on mathematical analysis of the market, of what has happened in the market before, and that helps you to make a prognosis. I mean, it's not definite, it's not definite predicament, but prediction, but it's a way to make a prognosis with such and such certainty, the market is going to behave in such and such way. And again, everybody heard about price action, we'll talk about it, that's the most popular way to do technical analysis, Fibonacci, Heikinashes, and so on and so on. We'll talk about it, and the most important, we'll not only talk about it, we'll be able to understand what it is and use it for your benefits, for making your life better, as it says in the wonderful videos that we just watched, for whichever goal you have, whether it's a short-time goal to buy a car or a house, or to go to school, or whether it's a global goal, like a strategic goal to say, let's say, save for your retirement or something else, you will be able to do this and you'll be able to understand how to make as much, how to generate as much profit as possible. Okay, so now let's talk about, we already mentioned what is cryptocurrency, but how do you transfer it from, let's say, me to you or vice versa? It's going either through, as I said, directly between you and me, or it goes through cryptocurrency exchanges. Just to say here, like little remark, when we are talking about cryptocurrency exchanges, it takes somewhat, idea of decentralization out of the thing, out of the business. Because what happens is that we will again have middlemen between us. The cryptocurrency exchanges are of three different kinds. There are centralized cryptocurrency exchanges, decentralized cryptocurrency exchanges, and like mixture of both of them. The first one is very, very simple and easy to understand. I mean, you place your asset on the exchange. Somebody else sees it there and buys it, not from you directly, but from the exchange. It's very, very similar to the stock exchange or the over-the-counter forex market, where you have somebody between you and your counterpart, whether it's a buyer or seller. And this counterpart, as I said, also, we don't like that, but that I'll explain why we need it in a second. But it counterpart has, not counterpart, this body inside has a possibility to control and benefit financially from your transactions. Why do we need it? Why do we go away from the idea of decentralization? Very simple. Decentralized, I mean, the currency exchange like this gives you security. gives you security and takes out the possibility, the necessity of understanding very, very deep what's going on. Because on decentralized currency exchanges, you will have to have very elaborate software. We'll have to understand a lot of things that you don't need in your day-to-day life. And most importantly, you're not secured. You're not as secured from bad will of your counterpart, the party that you are dealing with. And centralized currency exchanges take this worry out of your mind. Well, of course, for a price. Imagine what is exchange altogether. I mean, I'm sure all of you know that it's very simple. It doesn't differ at all from stock exchange, but instead of certain stock or commodity or currency, instead of that, cryptocurrency is listed on this exchange. Usually it's listed in a way that you know how much you would have to pay for one unit of the, of what you're buying. And usually that is enough to understand. Those of you who've seen it in live or in the movies, the ticker tape, where every second or so change of certain stock is changing, you already know what exchange is and how it works. What are these exchanges? This is a list, and we're not going to talk a lot about it right now. These are the most popular, and I'm not going to say best, but most popular crypto exchanges for like dealing with all kinds of assets. It's best overall. It's of course Coinbase. It's both for professional traders, and it's also good for novice traders. I hope at the end of our meetings, series of meetings, you will be in the first group of professional traders. But nevertheless, this is what right now it's very, very popular and easy. What's more important, easy to use. Then for professional traders, there are two. It's Binance Futures and Bitfinex. They are very, very versatile. They are very elaborate, and they can serve almost any purpose that you would need to fulfill while you're in the cryptocurrency market. Out of the decentralized exchanges, BISC is, but I do not recommend this to anyone who hasn't spent maybe at least a year in the cryptocurrency market, because every peer-to-peer action, as I already said, is changing your, is requires rather significant knowledge of what you, of how to proceed, and also requires certain type of elaborate software. And then there is for altcoins, I'll explain in a second what altcoin is Binance. Binance, regular Binance, it lists everything that is in the market. What is altcoin? Altcoin, I mean, sounds very, very nice and very cool, but altcoin is something that very easy to see what it is. It's every cryptocurrency, it's every coin, which is not Bitcoin. That's it. It's a very, very simple explanation. Every coin which is not Bitcoin is crypto, is altcoin. I don't know whether we'll have time to take over the major cryptocurrencies, major coins. I hope we will at the end of what we're talking about. But right now, we will talk about each of these exchanges in details. And we will, I will show you directly how to buy, how to sell, how to secure your deal, your trade on this, on these exchanges. Now, very, very important subject. I'm sure that some of you have previous experience in Forex trading. And to go and understand, you should really understand that what is similar and what is different, and what is actually better for you, what is best for you for trading. You know that both of these exchanges, both of these fields involve trading currencies. But the difference is that Forex market is huge, and it's well established for many, many years, if not generations. And crypto market, as I already said today, is something very, very new. It's has only like it's still a teenager, if you will. It's still like 11 years old, and that of course makes certain signs on it, which distinguishes it from the markets that are well established. The most important, signs that differ the markets is, one is the size of the market. I will show you on the next slide. I will show you a Forex market is something of the order of 5 trillion, the volume of the Forex market, of trade in the Forex market, something of the order of 5 trillion per day. The cryptocurrency market is not by the order of magnitude, I mean, but by several orders of magnitude, if I may say this in a real mathematical sense, not in a common day sense, smaller than the Forex market. And it reaches maybe only like a couple of hundred billions as opposed, as I said, to 5 trillion in the Forex market. What does it give us? First of all, it gives us most important thing that what keeps people in the cryptocurrency market. No, I trade both Forex and cryptocurrency. And when I actually very, very good in both of them. And if I do, I do this for myself, I do this for clients. And if I tell people that I can reach the return in the Forex market of, let's say, 10%, 7 to 10% a month, people from cryptocurrency slice of life laugh at this. They say, well, we can do it in one day. And that is the most important, in my view, difference between Forex market and cryptocurrency market. What happens is that the volatility of cryptocurrency market goes in no comparison with well-established and well-lined up Forex market, except for maybe major situations like Brexit or something of that sort, when the Forex market jumps out of its stream, flat line. But cryptocurrency market, it happens every day. Change of 5% per day, sometimes 10% a day, maybe even higher, is not something unusual for them for the cryptocurrency market. What does it give us? It gives us this ability to make better profit. You cannot go directly into the market and start guessing which way it goes. You need help from special quantum algorithms that are developed by Qubit technology. And that actually takes, it's already makes sure that every parameter is accounted for. Volatility, volume, price, everything is accounted for. And also, of course, the Forex always involves middlemen. In order to trade Forex yourself, you need to have, if I remember correct, I think something like either $200 million or $20 million. I don't know who you are, but for most people, this is something that's out of reach. In cryptocurrency market, otherwise, if you don't have this such an asset, we have to deal through brokers. And these brokers, again, control what you do. They allow you to do certain things. They do not allow you to do other things. Let's say they allow you to hedge. They don't allow you to hedge. They allow you to scalp. they don't allow you to scalp, you know, all this stuff. I'm sure you all have seen this in your trading experience, in your trading life. And also they take money, which is called in their case spread. And that spread is sometimes becomes very, very significant. There is no middleman in crypto market. And that's probably the most important and the biggest draw of everybody to the market. Now, what I was saying, this is just to illustrate, this is like the daily volume. I don't remember when I took this picture, but you can see this is $200 billion market cap of Bitcoin, 40, 15, 11, and so on. So altogether, it comes to maybe like $300 billion. And that is very, very negligible compared to the Forex market. And just for information, you will see how it changed within last 5 years. Bitcoin is always on top. That's the most important. And this is like the synonym of the field, Bitcoin. And others are either Ether, which is like second most important cryptocurrency, Ripple, Litecoin, Monero, and all others together. So you can see that how they change. We'll talk about it a bit later in more details. Now, just to mention, I mean, this is not something that is important for trading. This is something that I like very much. And this is something that actually, if you decide that you want to talk about it, we will talk about it. It's decentralized finance, DeFi. This is something that came up, well, half a year ago, not more than that. And this is a new attempt to take the finance control out of the big institutions. The name says it all, decentralized finance. I mean, it means that people can define and control their own financial transactions. And this decentralized finance is based on Ethereum protocol. Ethereum protocol is also a blockchain protocol, but it differs a lot from Bitcoin, because one of the major achievements of Ethereum, this was like second major blockchain, second major cryptocurrency design, is it allows people to define and organize smart contracts. We'll also talk about it in details, but smart contract is something that is very, very important in every actually slice of life, but especially where you don't see your counterpart, where you only have a set of symbols as his face, his or her face. Smart contract is something that allows you to do deals, trades, and contracts safely using special blockchain protocols. Propelled the price of Ethereum. It went within last, I think, from like 120 or so in sometime in beginning of the year, almost 400 or even more in August. Because as I said, DeFi is based on the Ethereum smart contract protocol. After August, I don't know whether it's related to real situation or to the Corona situation, but the interest subsided a little bit. Ethereum slided in price, but again, we know that there are certain cycles. We are now, I hope, at the beginning of the new cycle in rise of Bitcoin. And again, I will show you next time or one of the future times how well related different cryptocurrencies, change in price of different cryptocurrencies is. And I will show you that. And again, as I said, Bitcoin is like an engine who is moving, who is on the way up, pulls all other wagons filled with different cryptocurrencies with it. Let's hope for it, like they say, I'm sure you've heard this term, like they say, to the moon. And some people say this to the moon is going to be $50,000 next year. Some people say 100K. Some even say a million. I mean, we'll see. Let's see. But at least the process has started. As of last that I've checked this morning, it was 15,700. We'll see what it is tomorrow. Yeah, by the way, one more important difference between Forex market, I forgot to mention it, Forex market, Forex trading, and the cryptocurrency trading. Forex is open 5 days a week. 5 days a week, 24 hours a day, which I personally like because it leaves for me Saturday and Sunday as a day off, 2 days off. Cryptocurrency market is open 7/24. If you want to make money, you have to be there. Okay, now I will say something very, very important. Possibly, most important. I've saved this for the end. By the way, I will, let me make a short pause here to see what you writing to me because I don't have it on my screen. I will look it up. Maybe there are some questions. Okay, not too many questions. Actually, do not hesitate. Ask the questions. If there is, I will try to answer them right away. If I cannot answer them right away, because look, somebody who tells you that he or she knows everything probably knows nothing. I will, if I can't answer it right away, I will answer it next time. But so, algorithmic trading. This is probably the most important subject that of them all. And we're going to talk about it a little bit now and in great details later. What is it? Very simple. Algorithmic trading is a computer program that follows a defined set of instructions. These instructions are called algorithm and they are used to place a trade. This trade in theory, if the algorithm is put together in a proper way, will generate profits at a speed and frequency which cannot be even imagined with a regular human approach. What are the benefits of algorithmic trading? They're all on the screen. I can mention it. You can read them all, but I will say that anyway. Trades are executed at the best possible price. Best, here I have to mention something, which is very, very important here. Best possible price is based on the algorithm that it is derived from. These algorithms could be derived in different parameters. And this is again, it's my, as I said, my cup of tea. It's based on technical analysis. There is no algorithms, at least I don't use them, which are based on fundamental analysis. The parameters could be different. They could be, let's say, the price. Price action is the most popular way to prognose, to make prognosis in the market. It could be volume, it could be frequency, trade frequency, it could be more elaborate things like stochastic oscillators, like Fibonacci. All these parameters, all these indicators used in any combination to make special algorithm for trading. It's all that I'm going to say is obvious. I mean, trade orders placement is instant because the millisecond, microsecond, the indicators reach certain value, the trades is done. I mean, that is very, very important because, for example, if you trade manually, which I did up until recently, you look at the screen, you analyze in your mind what's going on, And only then you press the button. That takes time. The time, I'm sorry to say that, time is money. So they are time correct and instantly, as I said. Transactional costs are lower, obvious why. Then it could check different multiple market conditions. And also, I'm sure, again, if you're a trader, unfortunately, if you tell me that you never in your life you pressed the wrong button, I will be very, very surprised. I mean, I pressed it many times, and sometimes I still do it sometimes, even now, even though I consider myself an experienced trader. Very, very important, very, very important point, which is probably one of the most important for algorithmic trading, is that it could be backtested. Backtested means that we have data of all the market behavior within last in Forex. It's for many, many years in crypto. It's for last few years that exchanges exist. We can backtest it, see how it works. And this is what is algorithmic, quantum algorithmic trading is. And it, most of the time, it is used in the trade fashion, which is called high frequency trading. And that is probably one of the most important things that we are going to talk thinking, I named already several things that are most important, but maybe because I love them all, and we'll talk in details about all of them. So high frequency trading is something that actually came up very, very recently, maybe 10 years ago, in the like, not 10, maybe 15 years ago. And that was related to the influx of very good math and physics professionals into Wall Street, into financial world. Actually, I wasn't part of this movement back then, but the year when I got my PhD from New York University, PhD in physics, four more people got their degrees as well, and only myself went to do science, to into physics. All of them, all others were contracted by different financial institutions to create this algorithms. And the idea is very, very simple. You, like in algorithmic trading, you give the set of instructions and computer does it for you. And even this minor change in price can be used for making profit. And the more, the faster you analyze the market and the faster you perform the trade, most likely you will be making more profit. Here, there is, though there is a certain level above which we cannot go, I will talk about it in a second. So as I said, the traders with faster execution are more profitable, and it also adds liquidity to the market because more trades are done. No talk about algorithmic trading and high frequency trading will be complete without talking about technology, which allows, not yet, but will allow us to do the best possibility, the best possible, make best possible use of trading in the market. And that is quantum computers. As I said, the more trades you make, the faster you analyze the trades, the more likely you'd be with profits. There is a catch here. Regular conventional computers are limited in the speed. They are limited by the laws of physics, by the laws of thermodynamics. And what happens actually, in the development of the last few years, that is quantum computers. Maybe not even years, I mean, it's been first quantum computers, like operational quantum computers, even though still experimental, but already operational, possible, capable of solving mathematical problems, were created very, very recently. What's the difference, the major difference between quantum computer and a regular conventional computer is that a bit of a regular computer, you all heard the word bit, extern bit, could be either zero or one. It's a binary system. Every computer in the world operates on this binary system, conventional computer. If I'm not mistaken, when I said every, I already retracted, I will hedge a little bit. I think that every computer in the world operates like this. Quantum computer has a bit, which is a quantum bit, qubit, it's called, which is totally different. It takes use of quantum entanglement and quantum superposition. Every bit of quantum computer could be zero, one, or anything between. And that, again, we will talk about it a little bit in future meetings. I'll explain how it works for those who are interested. And that makes quantum computer millions times faster than a regular computer. There was a problem, I think it was IBM or Honeywell quantum computer that was developed recently. It's the test on, I think, 60 bits or 67 bits, or qubits, I'm sorry. It solved the problem within a matter of a few seconds or a few minutes. The problem which a conventional computer would take, sitting 10,000 years to solve. So this is future for both trading and for technology and for the humankind altogether. There are other topics that we are going to be covering, but again, the most important ones are the trading techniques, strategies, indicators, how to create and achieve profit in the market. And I will be happy to do this with you, and I hope we'll have these meetings weekly. We will get the schedule of different topics soon through Qubit Technologies, through our company. And I would also ask you to, as I said already, if you have questions, please send them to me. Let me have a look at them right now. Maybe you have questions already. Okay, no, I don't have that questions right now. Please, I love to answer questions. And in the meantime, I'm glad to spend this almost an hour with you. It was a pleasure. And hope to see you soon. Have a good weekend and a good week ahead of you. Bye.